To do a simple vertical weave-in, what you want to do is, just for a sample, knit up so many rows, and I think I did 10 rows here. If you're working this on a garment, of course, you're only going to do a couple rows to get started. And then you're going to pick the needles that you want to do the vertical weave in. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So to make it all even. And to start out, I want the yarn tail to be over on the left, and it's going to wrap, e-wrap, kind of, or wrap over the needle to the right. And I'm putting a clothespin, I'm hanging it on both of them just to start out with. After the first row, I will be taking off the the clothespin and just hanging it on the tail. So now I'm going to knit one row. And this is where I just take the clothespin off and hang it on the tail. I do this same thing when I do intarsia. Now if you want to continue going up the same needles, that's fine. That will create a nice design for you, a vertical stripe without doing fair isles. You may want to hold the yarns underneath so that they don't loosen up. And this is a good way to use up some of your scrap yarn that you have. And I think you could see how it's going up. Now if you want to do a design, like say I want to do a zigzag, first I'm choosing to go over to the right, so I take each needle to the right. Again, I'm wrapping the yarn from left to right. Knit a row. I take the next needle to the right. Okay, now say I want to go back to the left again. So I choose the needle just to the left of the last one knit. Now I'm going to reverse and I'm going to wrap the yarn over from right to left. So whatever direction your zigzag is going, you want the yarn to go that way. I'm sure you could see the arrows that are going here. Now I can continue and just making the zigzag like that, or I could continue going over to the left and making a wide zigzag. But say you want to have more than three colors on here. I'm going to show you with, I think I got it set up with seven colors and using your garter bar. So first of all, I took some coated paper clips and I unfolded them and I pulled a needle out far enough, and as you can see, I'm only got a little spot here. If you're doing the whole bed and you want to do, of course, if you only want to do the seven, this bed here where it doesn't have the gate post, I'm hanging them on the needle, so I pull the needle out. If I was to do this on the full bed, it may be a little bit harder, and I may have this laying on a table right in front of me here. So I would suggest doing it on a metal bed machine if you have it. You may want to crimp these together so that they stay in place well. Now I only did the center seven here, or I'm going to put them on the center seven. I could have another seven over here, another seven over here. I could have all the same color on this, or I could change different colors just to use up some of my, most of this is my waste yarn, but you know, I'm showing a sample so I could use it just to show you. But you know, you don't have to use some really good yarn to do up a swatch just to get used to this. So I'm only going to show, like I said, these seven needles, stitches in the center here, how this will happen. And there's many different designs that you could work up with this. Okay, you may want to have, you know, make up some of these butterfly bobbins. This is going to be too much yarn really for me for what I'm doing right here. But just so I don't have to cut it right now. Or if you get those plastic bobbins, to use that. Now I already have a few of the four of them already made, and I found that for the first row it's easier for me to take my latch tool and grab the yarn from behind the garter bar and then hang it on the needle. Now if you notice the yarn here where it goes over the hook from left to right and then from right goes down to the garter bar, I want to make sure that the yarn that's going to be worked is on the garter bar is going to the right. Now also I got a clothespin type thing on the yarn tails. I'm pulling that down as well as pulling the yarn through the garter bar. I'm pushing my work back. Now because I don't want my end needles that are holding the garter bar in place to be knitted, I put my carriage to hold so it won't knit those needles. But it won't knit these needles too unless I move them back. Now, if you have the metal bed machines with the gate pegs, you don't have to worry because you can click these ends onto the gate pegs and it won't even bother you. Now I do have to take and push the paper clip back so that the carriage can go over that needle on both ends. And there's the first set. Now if I go straight up, I'm just going to take the same seven needles. But let me start a zigzag. So I go one over to the right, I take my garter carriage off, and I'm going to hold the yarn in front so it's nice and tight, and I bring the yarn up between to the left of the needles, bring it up and then over so that it wraps over that one needle. I go ahead, hang my garter bar back on the end needles here. Push these needles back so they will be knit. Knit a row. And I didn't have those pushed back enough. Now I see where my end one is. I go over again. Lift up my garter bar. Start from the left and wrap them over one needle. So again, now I could look here, I could see the whites. I could take that needle there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now if I have other ones over here, you just look at it. Take the garter bar off, hold the yarn in place. Start wrapping from the left over to the right. Hang my garter bar back on. Push the needles in work back to, or in the middle here, back to the forward working position. This is where I push, I make sure that needle's all the way out to hold, and I push the paper clip back. And you just continue in that way for as long as you want. And once you get going, it does get pretty easy. Now say I want to do probably 4 rows of the same where I am right now. So it's not really a zigzag, but it's still making a design. So it's really up to you where you want to move your stitches over. Or if you just want to keep them going straight up and down. Now let's say that's my 4. So now I want to go back the other way. So I have a little straight right there. Now when I'm going that way, I want to wrap the yarn from the right to the left. As your bobbins get closer to the garter bar, go ahead and pull them down. If this is the bond machine, I keep forgetting to mention that, but you do need to push all those needles back. And the only reason I'm doing it is because I have a needle on each end holding the garter bar. Now, if you don't have these bobbins here or a weight on them, probably just take a clothespin to hang it on this tail here so that it holds it down. You need that weight on there for it to, as I'm wrapping it, it's keeping the end nice and tight where I could wrap it very easily. Of course, holding them in the front also helps. So it looks like I'm back at, or maybe I got one more to make it back in the same spot. And this is where I could go straight up. Now you see that little straightness there. I'm going to just stop right here. I'm going to do a few more rows of the blue and then take it off so that you could see it better. Okay, so here's the first one I did with going up straight and then going over on an angle, coming back on an angle. You could see better with the orange and the red. Now here's the second one. So I had to get the tails out of the way so that you could see how this is coming along. Now let me show you the front, which is, actually this is going to be the front and the knit side is going to be the back. Now here's the knit side, and you could faintly see some of these colors in the background. The blue over there is hard to see because it's blue background, but the red and the orange. You got the yellow, the dark blue, and the white showing up a little bit better. But this looks a lot nicer.